Tajon's a player that plays with a lot of emotion. I didn't know he played with so much emotion until I really watched the videotape. You see some of the faces he made. He made a shower when he got mad or something. So he definitely wears his emotion on his sleeve. If he continues to work hard and continues to do the right thing and work on his jump shot, he can be a really, really good player. And you know what the number one thing is, right? You got to work on those grades, right? Right? That's right. And be respectful to your teacher. Once that happens, everything going to go your way. All right? Okay, come on up and get the joke.
The next player also is an emotional player who has a tremendous jump shot. He has the ability to knock the shot down. He was playing against Yoderland. And they were playing us, and they was playing us real loose in the zone. I said, we need a shooter. We struggling right now. We got to get a shooter in there. So I put Nicholas in the game, hit about 3 shots in a row, got going. He has the ability to be a really good basketball player, too. One thing that if he does to listen to the coaches effectively and just do what the coach asks him to do, he'll be a fine basketball player. Come on up, Nicholas.
Jeremy's up next. Jeremy Nixon. I like Jeremy because Jeremy, if you don't really know basketball that much, and you really don't appreciate all the talents and all the skills and all the attributes that basketball acquires of an athlete, you probably wouldn't appreciate Jeremy. Jeremy's the type of player that I appreciate, that coach appreciates, because he's all out hustle. I mean, he dives for the ball, he's jumping for the ball, and he's high energy, and that's the type of player we like. And he started a little late, and he's a little behind as far as offensively, but his defense and his get after this, that's a new word that's made up. He can really become a good player. He has a lot of upside because his offense of game is behind right now. So those are things he can improve on. We can improve on shooting the ball. We can improve on dribbling the ball. But most kids don't want to improve on one thing, and that's working hard. And he has that already. So that's why he's going to be one of those kids that you see right now that you might not think big things of, but in a few years, he's going to be one of the people that are going to surpass some people you think are good right now because he works hard, because he dives on the floor for loose balls. All right? So, Jeremy, don't you keep that in mind. Don't let nobody talk you down or say anything about you. You keep your mouth closed like you've been doing, and you keep playing hard. Come on up, get the trophy.
This next player, he came to us late in the season as well, and we had to like whip him in shape. But he's an enjoyable kid. He's very charismatic, and he has leadership abilities if he just channel it in the right direction. And that's what we're working on. He's one of our most athletic and energetic kids on the team. He's a pleasure to have on the team who has came aboard. He's been one of our most challenging players, but I think that after this year working with us, Anasi is going to pan out to be a really good basketball player. Come on up, Anasi. Just real briefly, one of the things that we did with several kids on the team was, several kids on the team, when they parents that came to us and said, well, they won't be playing because they was acting up in school. One of the things we did was we gave little kids a notebook, and we told them to take it around to your teachers and have them sign it. Give us an updated progress report on how you're doing. And then that will be the determination whether you play or whether you sit until you learn your lesson. Anasi was, it was several kids on the team, but Anasi, just to point out one, Anasi was one of the ones that when his mom informed me that he was having difficulties, we put him on that notebook and he turned around immediately. All his reports came was progress. His teacher was calling me on the phone, thanking me, saying, you know, we're happy that, you know, our coaches are involved, that's doing some things. And, but we're glad that they make the turnaround. We're happy that all of the kids that were under that notebook made a turnaround. And that was impressive. This next kid, I have to play buffer in this situation. because I mean we got a bad cop already on the staff for this dude. So it's really difficult. I have to play good cop all the time. And anybody that knows the way I coach, I'm a screamer. But with this kid, I kind of take the hands off approach a little bit because I think he already gets screamed at enough. I know it's got to be difficult sometimes when you're the coach's son, because the expectations are a little bit more. But however, though, Kenneth was a leader on our team. He was one of the generals on our team, being at the point guard position, who leaded the team. And he's an individual that will continue to hard work and continue to do the things that he has been doing and improve on those things. He's going to be a terrific basketball player as well. And I want to thank him personally because he does a good service to me by driving his father crazy. And I sit back and I laugh and I love it and I get my kicks out of it. But coming up now, he's going to be a fine basketball player in the future, Kenneth Danzy.
Me and Coach's type of player. Yes. He's a throwback. Alright? He's the type of player that plays. He played like how we played basketball when we were coming up. Tawan Williams. He's the guy right there that's really old school in his style. I remember one, he's really short. And he hope he get a growth spurt, hopefully. I remember one game, at the Albany YMCA, it was a rebound that needed to be gotten. And Tawan jumped so high, everybody in the crowd was like, whoa. I mean, this kid was near the backboard, y'all grabbing the rebound. It was unbelievable. I was like, I was in awe. I really was, the way he jumped. And but he's a smart kid. He's a bright kid. He knows a lot of things. And that goes to tell you, as parents and as older people in this room, when we're around the kids, these kids absorb a lot. They really do. They're paying attention when you think they're not. And I can tell you pay attention in the classroom. We asked some questions, we had a workshop, and the presenter asked some questions. He was really a sharp individual in that classroom. And I just wanted to continue that because when you're bright in the classroom, it really translates on the basketball court as well. But you move on the court in a different kind of way than other kids do. You don't move in a straight line. You move at angles. You know, that's how the game is played, at angles. And that's the way you play the game. Your defense is tremendous, and that's the reason why I like you. You remind me of myself. My thing was defense and dribbling when I was coming up. And you keep the dribbling, and you work on your jump shot, and you keep the attitude that you have, you'll be fine. Now, I did hear some issues with you this past week, okay? And your uncle told me, all right? We need to stay away from those type of things, right? Right? Especially when it's the same person that you're involved with doing that same thing. Okay, so you are too smart for that. We don't want to lose you. You hear me? We don't want to lose you for no reason. Because mommy won't, you know, made a decision. And you know, it could be really dire for you. All right? So you need to think about that. Any decision you make, you need to make sure you think about your family. All right? Think about the team. Think about the community. Any decision, all you guys make, you need to think about that. How's it going to affect myself, my family, you know, the community? Anything that you do. All right, so you guys think about that. Come on up tomorrow.
This next individual, I have a pleasure of introducing as well because he's a defensive-minded kid, and he's a funny kid, too. To be one of our biggest kids on the team, we spread the floor with him and let him run the point sometimes. He's that nimble for his size. And he had, look at him, he's a bubbling personality. He picks up the team, and when he's up, for the most part, when he's upset for the most part for the right reasons. Because either we're losing, or the team camaraderie is down at that point, and he just likes to win, and you can see the smile on his face, he enjoys the game. I remember one time we was up in Connecticut, and it was just funny watching him on tape. They had got a steal on us. And to see everybody running back, and see the biggest guy on the court beating everybody down the floor trying to get the ball back, I said, wow. And he got the ball back. I said, wow. But Lavion has a lot of upside to him. He has a lot of upside to him. We just recently noticed that you've been pouting just a little bit in our last tournament. And we don't want that. Because if you subtract that and you keep on the positive mindset and keep enjoying the game of basketball like you have a tremendous, tremendous upside. And you're going to be a fine basketball player. Because, like I said, to be the biggest guy in the court, and we spread the floor a lot of times because no other big guy on your other team can stick with him. And so you keep up the good work, and you keep listening to coaches, and you're going to be fine. Come on up, Lavion.